Our fully customizable Tesla stalks are officially out and I'm here today to do a full unboxing, show you how to install them, walk you through the setup process and tell you everything you need to know about them. So, let's dive in. This is how the Sexy Stalks bundle box looks. If you think your car doesn't need two levers, you can get only the left or the right in the standalone section at enhauto.com. When you first open it, you will see the elegantly made stalks with their beautiful finishes. On the bottom of each stalk, you will find a marking that tells you which one is the left and which one is the right. There is also a small carton box containing the commander, which is the brain of the entire operation, the wire which connects it to your Tesla, and a pry tool to help you install it, but more on that later. Inside the box, you will find a cleaning wipe and an extra double-sided tape that you can use if you ever have to remove the stalks and put them back on. Now, let me show you how to position these bad boys properly. Even though the stalks use strong custom-made double-sided tape, which aims to make the installation process easy and doesn't require disassembly of the steering wheel, we recommend doing the following steps on a preconditioned cabin with a temperature of around 21 degrees Celsius. Once the cabin is warm, take the provided wet wipe and carefully clean the area where the stalks go, removing any dust and oily spots. Then leave it to dry for a couple of minutes before proceeding to the next step. If your steering wheel column needs more polishing, get a warm, wet towel or anything else you like to clean your car with. This step is essential for the adhesive to make a strong bond with the surface underneath. As we have said in the past, the stalks installation takes less than a minute, but we suggest you take your time and follow the next steps. At the bottom of each stalk, you will see arrows with markings. They are meant to help you follow a proper alignment so you can rest assured that both units are placed symmetrically, but you can always just eyeball it. We recommend placing the base of the stalk about 2 mm from the edge of the steering wheel column so it doesn't rub when you spin the wheel. Also, ensure that the edge of the stalk is aligned with the edge of the column by moving it a bit until you feel it sits in its place. Then press gently with one hand while pulling arrow number 1 upward, following the guided lines with the other. Then spin the wheel to get better access to arrow number 2 and pull it towards you. Once both plastic seals are stripped off, press the base firmly against the steering wheel column for about 5 seconds. Finally, pull down arrow number 3, which is there to preserve the battery's lifespan before it gets into use. Even though the double-sided tape we created is strong and durable as every other adhesive there is, it gets stronger with time, so we recommend not using the stalks in the next 48 hours to harden properly. If you live in a colder climate, finding a place to keep your car indoors for that period is essential, unless you're okay with keeping the cabin preheating on for the next couple of days. The Commander is the unit that communicates with all of our sexy gadgets via Bluetooth and sends signals to the car. It can also do numerous automations, which you can learn more about in the video at the right top bar. It connects at the diagnostic port located at the front right A pillar on all newly built Model 3 and Ys, whether your car is left or right-hand drive. For the installation, you need the pry tool that comes with all of our bundles. To feel safe, you can power off the car via the main screen and pull back the right seat so you have more room to work with. This Model 3 was built in 2024 and the first thing you need to do is to remove the rubber seal all the way back to the passenger door. Afterward, pop open the triangular part at the side of the glove box area with the provided pry tool. Start from the bottom and gently work your way up until you have enough leverage to pop the piece out. If it's your first time removing this piece from your car, please note that it could feel a bit harder, but giving it a little shake will help loosen it. Once you remove it, you can access the main plastic pin that keeps all the wires tucked in. Pop it open without applying too much force and then pull out the entire L-shaped piece starting from the back. Once you can access all the wires, look for the two types of ports. The diagnostic port is wider and can come in two colors, white or blue, depending on where your model was built. It can be neatly tucked at the back of this cable mess, but it will be there on all cars. In it, we plug the male side of our cable and the female side will stay freely like this in case you want to add any other third-party accessory to it. Then we need to look for these smaller plugs, which are connected to one another. This is where the Commander will get its power from, so you will have to disconnect the original wires and daisy chain ours into it. When this is done, the Commander will immediately start flashing green. Before you put back everything together, you can go through the next step, where we pair the Commander with the Sexy app, just to make sure that everything works as planned, and then start assembling everything back by following these steps. Place the L-shaped plastic piece back, aligning it with its pins. Put the main pin back in place by squishing the front part of it, and once in place, push it in. Then put the triangular cover on the front side first and then press it until it clicks. Lastly, put the rubber seal back, starting from the back to the front, making sure not to stretch it, but to follow its natural curve. When setting up the Stalks for the first time, we must ensure that newly installed Commander is paired with the Sexy app. To do so, go to the Commander tab and follow the pop-up that asks you to connect a new Commander. Sometimes, for security reasons, it might ask you for a verification step, which is done by pressing the right scroll wheel twice. When you do so, press Continue and the pairing should be completed. Then we need to check if there is a pending update for the Commander, which can be seen from the Sexy app's homepage. If so, make sure to install it first, otherwise your Stalks might not be able to detect the unit. After the update is done, it's time to pair your new Stalks, and you do that from the tab at the bottom of the home screen. Here the step is similar to when you were pairing the Commander. Once you see this message, you need to press the side button of the Stalk. After the pairing is done, you can connect your second Stalk by swiping left on the screen and repeating the same process. Once the Stalks are paired to the app, they should automatically connect to the Commander. If for some reason you think they are not connected, doing a factory reset or holding the side button for 15 seconds might help. You can also contact our support team from the email provided in the description below. From the Stalks tab, you can do all the customizations, so let's go over what's currently coded with software version 5.2. Here you see the three pre-assigned actions which you can always change by just pressing the icon and selecting your favorite feature from dozens of options. A second and a third action can be added to the same movement of the lever or the button by assigning it to the double or long press. Please note that the single press action will be slightly delayed if you add a double or long press actions. That's because the Stalk needs 1/3 of a second to be able to recognize if you want to activate action number 1 or action number 2 before the input gets triggered. That's why we recommend leaving the important features that you use while driving only as a single press option, so there is no delay whatsoever. Another great feature that we have added is the possibility of assigning actions based on the drive state you are in. For example, I have made it so that when I'm in drive, the upward movement of the left Stalk triggers the right turn signal, but the same movement, when the car is in park, will open the right door. And the double pull will move my passenger seat backwards so that my co-pilot can get inside the car easier. And once again, these options are fully customizable, so you can make them fit your driving style. Let's go for a quick drive so I can show you the Sexy Stalks in action. After using the Stalks for a couple of months, I have found a perfect setup for myself, and here is how it looks. While driving, I have set the left Stalk to control the turn signals. One pull down will activate the left turn signal, and the second pull will dismiss it. If I want to quickly switch between the left and the right indicators, I just pull the lever up in the opposite direction. It's that simple. I used to have the left button set to activate the washers, just as on the traditional Tesla Stalk, but recently I have switched it to toggle my autopilot, which has totally changed my driving experience. Now, when I hit the open road, I can fully drive only by using my left hand. Pretty cool, right? For my right Stalk, I have assigned it to act like a gear selector. So one pull down will put the car into drive, and if I pull it up, it will go into reverse. I was thinking of assigning the park feature to the side button, but since on the Highland the car auto shifts into park when you unbuckle your seatbelt, I have assigned the dome lights feature to it, which will turn on the interior lights for me. Now, some of you will say, what will happen if I pull the lever up while moving forward? Will it put the car in reverse? Don't forget that we are not hacking your cars, but only extending what they can do. Just like you cannot change the gears while driving above a certain speed on the older models or through the screen, you will not be able to do that with the Sexy Stalks either, since the car has protection systems implemented. Go down in the comments and tell us what features you would assign to your Stalks if you could. As you know, we have made our Stalks fully wireless, and for that we are using a CR2032 battery that can withstand over 6 months of hardcore use and over a year of moderate use. But we have made replacing it easier than ever without having to take the Stalks off the steering wheel column. On the bottom of each Stalk there is a small tray that you need to pull down to access the battery. Then simply take it out and put the new one with the positive side facing upward. It's that easy. Also, we have made the Sexy app notify you when the battery is running out, so it doesn't stop working mid-drive. Removing the Sexy Stalks is as easy as putting them on, but since the custom double-sided tape we have made is meant to last, make sure to follow these steps when taking them off. First, get a blow dryer and point it directly at the base of the Stalk at mid to high temperature, just so the glue can become softer. After a few seconds, use a pry tool to get in between the Stalk and the steering wheel column. and gently start working your way in by pulling away the base of the stalk from the column. It would be a smart idea to place a small cloth between both plastics just to avoid any potential scratches. And just like that, the lever is off and the car is as it was when you first got it. If you need to put the stalk back on, make sure to wipe down the steering wheel column, remove the double-sided tape you already used, replace it with the additional one we have provided in each box, and leave it to dry out for a couple of days, just as you did when you first installed it. Well, this was it. We are super excited to hear your feedback about our newest product and how it will help you transform your driving experience. If you didn't know, we always update our gadgets based on the requests we get from our users, so feel free to share your recommendations with us in the comment section of this video. Or just join our Discord channel where thousands of like-minded people already are. I will leave a link in the description below. Thank you for watching and I will see you in the next one. Bye!